What's going on, guys? So I wasn't expecting this. That's why the intro is not taking place in that time. But this is going to be a three-part series. This first video is going to be kind of an introduction on what you're going to need, all the information. The second part is going to be me making baits with Pauly for the first time, him telling me what to do in the process of it. And the third part is just going to be me solo. And if I need him, I'll ask him some questions. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoy this video.
What's up, guys? So some of the things you're gonna need to start off, you need yourself some worm oil, any worm oil. You can get them from multiple companies. Dead On Plastic has worm oil, Bait Plastics has worm oil. I use Do It. You need to get yourself some glitters. I have all kinds of glitters, it's all different sizes. The main size is used in a lot of baits is 0.015, you can get 0.025, you can get 0.08, 0.05, which is really small, which the 0.05, you can actually do some cool things with it. You can almost make like its own color out of it without putting colorant. You just use clear plastisol, put the 0.05 in, put a ton of it in, and basically makes like its own color. Also, we have some... You're gonna need colorants. I use a lot of Lureworks for glitters. I find these to be the best. And for colorant as well, I use Lureworks. Also, MF. MF makes some good stuff. MF Manufacturing. And Dead On Plastics, they have a good assortment of colors and also color shifts. Like this is a color shift. So this is pretty cool once you shake it up. So you're gonna need colors, glitters, worm oils. You're gonna need heat stabilizer. Again, a lot of people make it. Make sure the heat stabilizer that you get works with the plastisol that you get, because some don't work well with others. Also, you're gonna need some kind of, if you want, like some kind of softener. Also, they sell hardener. And then you can get stuff like this, like a heat gun, so you can heat the molds. Obviously, you're gonna need some molds. This is a blending block to shoot laminates. This is how it works on the inside. That's how that works. One color comes in here, the other color comes in here. They meet in the middle. That's how you make a laminate. You also, when curing, and laying them out, you want to either use like parchment paper or some kind of like metal sheet. Works good. You can speed up some of the curing process by putting them in water. I don't put them in water. It's like a shocking process. I don't really do that. I just kind of lay them out and I leave them as is. I let them cure. You got to cure anywhere from 24 to 48 hours. A true cure on these baits would be 2 weeks, roughly. You're gonna need yourself some kind of heat gun, something that could tell the temperature. It's an infrared heat gun. Dual injector, that's to make the laminates. Or you can do a single injector. You can get these cheap on like Do-It Molds, Quality Injectors, and more on Facebook. You can pick up an injector from Bass Tackle. You're gonna need yourself some Pyrex cups. Any size is fine.
They're a little full from just making these.
You're gonna need obviously a microwave. I have a degassing chamber. So like a lot of plastic sauce says mix, don't shake. The sticker was here, it said mix well. But I shake mine because again I have this, I have the degassing chamber so I can take all the air back out of it. So you don't have any air pockets. And obviously you're gonna need some kind of plastic sole. I use dead on plastics. I have finesse drop shot blend. I use craw tube blend in floating and craw tube blend in sinking. There's obviously other brands out there. You got bait plastics, this is dead on, MF manufacturing, there's Calhoun's. You got plenty of options to choose from. And also when you're making baits that don't float and you want them to sink, you want to add salt. So this is another thing needed. You don't need it, but if you want it, if you like salt in your baits, it's a good way to go. Also, you'll need one of these if you work in a cold environment. This is just a griddle. You can get one at Walmart cheap, like $20. This actually helps to heat up your molds. And if you have hand pour molds, you put this on, set this to the right temp to about 350. Put your molds on here, preheat the molds, and then you leave it on. And when you're hand pouring, it actually helps to form and bond it so you don't have any cold cracking.
And then from there, guys, he just goes in and he does above and beyond for all his work. It's high quality, very nice baits. He also does jigs. And what other stuff do you do?
I make jigs. I make football jigs, swim jigs, net heads. I make chatter baits.
He does it all. So
basically, yeah.
He's the go-to person. He does, like I said, great quality work. So if you guys are looking for baits from him, check him out. I'll leave a link down in my description. But so if you're going to get into that, you're going to need some more complicated stuff. All this other good stuff that he has. And then the lead maker over here. But today we're just sticking to the basics of making worms and some soft plastics.
You're also going to need some kind of clamp so you can clamp your mold. Some molds come with these screw clamps. Most people like to take these off. You can take them off with like an Allen key. They come right out and then you just clamp them. I like to use mine. I like to leave mine on. But other molds, like these molds from, say, Do It, it's nothing to clamp. There's no clamp on it. So that's what I use those clamps for. Work nice.
So we're going to get going, start making some baits. I think we were just waiting for the tubs of the previous baits he just made to dry. So we can peel that out, start melting down some plastics, and come back with some results for you guys. During this whole process, he'll be talking about what it takes, what temperature you should be at, and how much you should add, stuff like that. So you guys get a good grasp on what you're going to need if you guys want to do it at home too, just like I do. But yeah, to be continued.
Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget, check out part 2 and 3. They will be coming up soon.